A Dog's Life was really a transitional film for Chaplin in a lot of ways. It ran almost 35 minutes, so he was clearly getting ready for the longer films. The photo you see here is from a film called The Kid, which was one of his most popular longer films. He was also making another change right after this. The music that you've been hearing so far was just added on. People would have played any music that they wanted to in the theater. But Chaplin was a wonderful composer. And so by the late 1920s, he had begun to compose his own music for his films. And films like The Circus had his score. The score that you're going to be hearing in City Lights was written by Chaplin. It's absolutely beautiful. And you'll see that it's very, very closely coordinated with the story, to the point at one point when it appears two people are talking, what comes out of their mouth is just blah, blah, blah. And he's got certain jokes that gear into to the sound. Chaplin would compose music for his movies from there on in, including a number of hit songs like Smile. Really, I think in many ways, Chaplin, as well as being a great actor and great director, probably could have made it as a composer. So we're going to move now forward up to part of City Lights, which is the film we're going to see. City Lights was made in 1931. Sound had already come into film in 1929, and Chaplin did consider making City Lights as a sound movie, but he decided that the little tramp had never spoken and should not speak. And in fact, up through modern times, which will be the next movie after City Lights, the tramp never speaks. In kind of a final joke, he does sing in that movie, but sings in gibberish, and then walks off without ever having delivered dialogue. So 1931, City Lights is a sound movie, and the sound is synchronized, but it's done totally in pantomime. One of the most famous scenes from it is the boxing scene, which really shows Chaplin's amazing abilities at footwork, acrobatics, and at really great physical comedy.